This morning, Wake Forest University's baseball coach is recovering from major surgery along with one of his players.
It's such a great story. He donated one of his kidneys to save that player's life. Sports director Kenny Beck has the story.
On this cold February afternoon, Tom Walter is just Wake Forest University's baseball coach. But to one of his players, he is a lifesaver.
As soon as the testing started, I was on board with the idea that if I were a match, I was going to do it.
Walter is donating a kidney to one of his freshman outfielders, Kevin Jordan. Kevin Jordan, who was drafted by the New York Yankees last summer, suffers from ANCA vasculitis, a disease which has dropped his kidney function down to 8%. Not one of his blood relatives was a suitable donor.
When we recruit these young men, we talk a lot about family, and we talk about bringing them into our family. And I think a decision like this is one that any one of us would make for a family member, and that's how all of our coaches feel about all of our players.
James Harris was Kevin's roommate in the fall, but had to move out when he started in-home dialysis. Kevin was hooked to a machine from 11 at night until 8 in the morning.
I think it's pretty inspiring for the team, you know, because we're all healthy out here playing ball, and we have another teammate struggling for his life.
The team motto for Wake Forest baseball this season is, "What are you willing to sacrifice to make us better?" Players say Coach Walter came up with that long before ever deciding to donate a kidney to Kevin.
Kevin will receive a medical redshirt this season. Doctors believe he should be able to lift weights with the Demon Deacons this summer so he can begin to regain the 30 pounds he's lost. And while it's unclear how much time his coach will miss, the impact of this story on this team couldn't be more clear.
The coach is willing to do something that extreme for one of his players. You know, we got to be willing to go through a wall, you know, to win games for him. Coach Walt's a great guy. So I can understand him doing what he's doing.
If this story gets out and somebody somewhere in California or Wyoming decides to donate an organ to somebody based on what they heard in this story, then, you know, I think that's a great thing.
That is amazing. Both surgeries took place yesterday down at Emory University Hospital.
Yeah, and that's very, very risky for mm-hmm. both of them. So I really admire him for doing that, because that's pretty scary. But, you know, he's obviously an awesome coach and, you know, standing by what he was talking about family and all of that. So that's really great. The lead surgeon says both those procedures went very well, and they are expected to fully recover, too.
Yeah, and this is a story, of course, we'll continue to follow. So tune in tonight at 5. We'll have the very latest on Coach Walter and Kevin's recovery.